Hello friends, welcome to HTML video tutorial series. I double click on my profile folder, I right click on default.html page, open with the Firefox. In the previous video tutorials, we understood how we can create our own profile by using just HTML. There, we created contact form, we added links to my works, we created list of hobbies, etc. I hope you guys have understood how to create our own profile. I suggest you people to create your own profile by using HTML by following different layout. Try it. And you can observe here, browser is displaying only one web page at a time. At present it is displaying default.html page. If I click on contact me link, it is showing now contactme.html web page. If I click on my works link, it is displaying myworks.html web page. It shows only one web page at a time. The question is it possible to display more than one web pages at a time in the browser window? Answer to this question is yes. It is possible to display more than one web pages in a browser at a time. And how do we do that? By using HTML frame set tag. So in this tutorial, we are going to learn and understand HTML frame set tag and HTML frame tag. Then let's get started. I click on the start. I click on notepad. We know that every HTML page begins with opening HTML tag and ends with a closing HTML tag. We know that HTML is divided into two different sections. One is the head section. Another one is the body section. In the head section, we know that we can put the title tag. Here I write frame set tag demo closing title. And in the body section, I am not writing anything. File, save as. I save the file at desktop with the name default.html. In double quotations, I put the name and then I click on the save. You can see that default.html page got created. I right click, open with the Firefox to see how it looks. You can see that the browser is displaying default.html page and title is set to frame set tag demo. As I told, to divide the body section into different parts or different frames, we take help of frame set tag. To use frame set tag, we need to omit body tags, opening tag as well as closing tag. Instead of body tag, we use opening frame set tag. Instead of closing body tag, we use closing frame set tag. You can see, to use frame set tag, we should not use body tag. We need to omit the body tag. Frame set tag is used to divide the body section into different sections or different frames. If I say file, save, go to browser and refresh, nothing happens actually. First thing, we need to decide how we want to divide the section. Do we want to divide this body section into different columns or into different rows? I want to divide this body section into two different rows. So to do that, we use rows attribute. And then we have to give value here either in percentage or in pixels. I give in percentage. I write here 50%, 50%. That indicates I want to create two different sections of body section. The first section height is going to be 50%. The second section height is going to be 50% because we are dividing the body section into two rows. They indicate height. If it is columns, then these values indicate width of each section. Okay. And when we add these percentages, remember that the sum should be 100%. If we do only this much and say file, save, go to browser and refresh, nothing happens. You can see that no change because we have not created any frames yet. To create frame, inside the frame set tag, we use frame tag. And frame tag is an unpaired tag. You can see I have written both opening and closing frame tag in one tag. And here I am going to create one more frame. Now we have two different frames. File, save, go to browser and refresh. You can see that browser has divided the body section into two different frames. Frame 1 height is 50%. Frame 2 height is 50%. We can give names also to frames. So here I give name frame frame 1. This is going to be frame 2. Then I say file, save, go to browser and refresh. No problem. Now I want to know how do we display different web pages So here in the frame 1, I want to display one web page. Here in frame 2, I want to display another web page. How do we do that? Let's understand. I am going to create two more web pages, start notepad. In this notepad, I am going to type HTML, closing HTML. Then I say head, closing head, body, closing body. And in the head section, I am going to write title, title. Frame 1, closing title, and in the body section, I am going to write frame 1. File, save as, and I give the name as frame1.html. Both sides I put double quotations and click on the save button. Frame1.html got created. Now I change this 1 to 2, this 1 to 2. File, save as, this is going to be frame2.html. I put both sides double quotations and click on the save. You can see frame2.html also got created. Now, how do we link these web pages to frame? Here, we are going to use an attribute called as src attribute. There, we have to give the name of the file or web page to be displayed. frame1.html. Here, I am going to write src. In double quotations, I am going to write frame2.html. Now, I save this file, save, right-click, open with the Firefox. You can see that in the first frame, frame1.html got displayed. In the second frame, frame2.html is getting displayed. Same thing we can try in Google Chrome. Right click, open with the Google Chrome. You can see that we have two different frames again. In the first frame, frame 1 is displaying. In the second frame, frame2.html page is getting displayed. We can try in Internet Explorer also if we want. Open with the Internet Explorer. You can see that frame 1, frame 2 are created. In the frame 1, frame1.html is getting displayed. In the frame 2, frame2.html is getting displayed. This is how we can display more than one web pages using the frame set tag. It's very, very useful. Now, if I change this rows to columns, our body section is going to get divided into columns. 50% indicates width of the first frame. This 50% indicates the width of the second frame. File, save. Let's see how it looks. Right click, open with the Firefox. You can see that this time we have columns. In the first frame we have frame1.html, in the second frame we have frame2.html. Hope you guys have understood how we can use the frame set tag, how to create frames and link web pages to frames. For this tutorial, this much is enough, friends. In the next tutorial, we get more information on frame sets. For more benefits, please subscribe and don't forget to like, comment and share these videos with others so that everyone will get benefited. Keep learning, keep coding, keep sharing. See you in the next tutorial, guys. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much.